Alma Bustamante. I am a journalism major and I'm a senior graduating this December, 2018. I think the main reason why I want to be a journalist in the future is because I want to inform people and let the community know what's going on, you know, actions that maybe they need to take or just information they should know in order for them to like make more well-rounded decisions about things that are affecting them. I think the toughest part as a student overall, it's just pretty much that I'm working full-time and I go to school full-time, because I know a lot of students here at Tech that either they have a part-time job or they, you know, they're just focusing completely on school, which I think that's awesome. You know, they really do focus on school and all that stuff. But I've been working full-time since I started college, so that's been really hard. My ultimate goal, like what I would, you know, wish I could do, is to be, of course, working for a Spanish-speaking news organizations. One of the main ones here in the United States is Telemundo Univision, but I want to be a news anchor, hopefully for like, you know, the best news station, like the newscast in one of those stations. I think that would be my dream job. But of course, I know that I have to work hard, start from the bottom, and just, you know, build my way up there. But that's what I'm trying to do, at least. You know, I'm getting an education so I can learn the skills, learn what's necessary for me to know, and just, you know, go on from there. One of the toughest things about being a journalist in the future, a professional journalist, is going to be probably keeping up to date on, you know, how to tell the stories better, or, you know, if there's like new programs or new things that I can do to improve, you know, my stories, the videos that I make, the interviews that I make. I think that would, that's, you know, that's hard, because it's really easy to just fall in like the same routine and, you know, not renew yourself in a way. And I think that's going to be the biggest challenge. I'm also not only doing this for myself, but for my family. And I don't think a lot of people know this yet, but I have a daughter. She's 5 years old. I have a five-year-old daughter, and she's also living with them, so she's not living with me, which is really hard on me. But like I said, that's part of the struggle. I feel like that's not very common as a Tech student, you know, to be a single mother, a full-time student, have a full-time job, and like be a first generation. It's just, I feel like I have a lot of adversity, you know, against me. And I'm doing this for her, you know, I really am. I talk to her and she's like, you know, how was school, Mom? And, you know, it's just, what can you say? You know, you want to do the best for her. You know, she's my number one priority. She's what keeps me going. Also my family, my parents, we've been through a lot. So whenever things get tough, I think about my daughter. I think about my parents. I think about my ultimate goal of getting an education for them and to better our future.